All right, we're here with UFC fighter Kurt Pellegrino. Your last fight was against Diaz. Yes. An interesting end to fight. You dominated the fight pretty much the whole way. And you got caught. Everybody gets caught. I'm wondering what about his reaction, the end of that fight. Did that offend you at all, what he was doing, or did you just kind of blow it off?
I haven't watched it, so I really don't know. I hear he did something crazy, but that's okay. If I fought him any day, that'd be the only time he's ever going to beat me in his whole entire life. I was going through a rough time in my life at that point. I still lost. That was the best Kurt Pellegrino that entered that cage that day. I trained harder than I've ever trained in my life. But at the end of the training camp, I was really burnt out, didn't even want to fight. No excuse. I still lost, but I'll give him the win. You know, and I'm fighting some inner demons with myself right now to get myself back up there again. But, man, if I was getting beat up that bad and knew I would never beat that kid ever again, I'd probably do that too.
Well, I mean, the good news coming out of that fight was you dominated the whole thing.
Yeah.
I mean, it was a pretty dominant performance. Up to that point, were you happy with how you fought?
I haven't watched a fight, and I honestly feel that I was stuck in glue the whole time when I was fighting. So, to me, I didn't even fight good.
I would tell you, it didn't look like it.
People told me I was doing phenomenal, but yeah. I actually felt I wanted to stand up, so I kept taking him down because I felt like I couldn't move on my feet. I was training with Buddy McGurk, and I couldn't even throw a punch. So I was only taking him down because it was easier to be on the floor to be in his guard than it was to stand up and have no willpower to go forward. So it was a very humbling experience when you train for something for like 8 months and you can't go.
Right. Well, now legendary, the Alberto Crane fight where your tooth actually went through your bottom lip. You have the scar. Now, how do you fight through something like that? I mean, your tooth going through your bottom lip's not that little of a deal. It's a pretty big gash, and does it bother you the rest of the fight?
I really didn't even know I was kicked in the face. I didn't even know I had a hole. All my corner told me was after the fight was, in between the rounds was that he kicked you. I was like, oh. I mean, I really didn't even know, to be honest with you. And I don't know. All the fighters that are out there that said they got punched and rocked, they come back. I don't even think you know you're even rocked. All of a sudden, you just wake up and you're like, where am I? And you kept going. People say that, I'm tough. I have the best shit in the world. I don't want to take credit for being tough. You know what I mean? I don't even know where I was. You know what I mean? If it was a little bit harder, maybe I wouldn't be here today. You know what I mean? So I don't know. Maybe I do have a good chin, but I don't think he hit me on the right spot. And he gave me time to wake up by playing jiu-jitsu with me.
Right.
Where I think he should have been, trying to chase me. He gave me time to wake up, and I'm way better than him on my feet. He should have attacked more, because I was out until the very end where I started putting my combinations together.
Well, yeah, at the end of the fight, obviously, you won the fight. But what do you do to get yourself back into a mindset of clearing the cobwebs? And you see fighters all the time that don't recover. How do you shake it off and come back?
I hate to lose more than anything in the world. Even if I played Japanese checkers for the first time, I don't want to lose. And it actually will make, I'll think about that game of Japanese checkers all day until I figure out how to win, And I play internet chess, actually, on MSN.com. And I think I'm like 5-130. It gets me nuts. But I just want to keep, I want to win. It felt good winning those five, So I think that from being a little kid, I've lost 4 times my whole career wrestling. And grappling, I've lost 3 times, and they're all like world champions.
Right.
And fighting, I've lost 4, and I tell you what, it makes me nuts that I've lost 4 times in fighting. So I just hate to lose so bad. When Alberto, I was there in the head.
Right.
I was mentally stable to keep going, mentally strong. And I went from Alberto to Nate, and I wasn't there. I wasn't physically there. And if I get that opportunity again, the fans of the UFC will really see that wasn't me, This is me now.
Right.
So I'll be fighting again soon, and I'll be back.
Have they, obviously UFC brings back exciting fighters, which you are. So
I'm there.
Have they named a opponent for you at all? Is there anybody you'd like to fight?
God bless anyone who takes that fight, because I have a training camp going away. It's going to be for real. And if you take that fight, like I tell everyone, train really, really hard. but I want you to train harder than that because I'm going to be really upset and mad and a vengeance to win. I never lose two times in a row. So I don't care who they get me to fight. I'll take the loser of the title fight. Just to prove to the fans I'm not here to fight easy fights. I'll fight the best guy. So it doesn't matter to me.
Raga, good luck.
Thank you.
Thanks.